What's happening, folks? And welcome to another episode of Stars of Tomorrow, a series, where we look at some of the best players on FM20 and we see how they get on over the course of their careers, both players that I pick and players that you guys give me in the comment section. Now, obviously, this is a player that I have picked, so if you want to get your player in, I would say be as quick as you can, because obviously I do have to record ahead to make sure I content regular content on the series. And I do reply to your comments with a thank you and a idea, if not specific episode, of when it's going to be uploaded. Two things you have to do. All you've got to do is check the playlist, make sure your player's not been done already, and also check that... Also, make sure you give as much info on the player as possible. And down below are my links to my second channel, which has my Jedi Fallen Order Let's Play, and also my Twitch links and Twitter links, always, and Discord down below as well, where you can all get in touch with me if you feel like you need to or want to. Now, as you can see, we're doing Pedri today, and we've got the webcam. I'm just not going to put webcam on these videos. I don't think we need it. It just, because the nature of the series is quite not reactive. It's just me talking about a player, and it might take away some of the things on the screen a bit as well. So I'm not going to put webcam on. Plus, it means I can record it wherever I want. I can sit here in my pajamas or underwear, which I'm totally not doing right now. I'm not really, but you get the point. But also, you know, I have a bit of a thing, like, I don't like recording during the evenings because I hate how it looks in the light. I prefer to record during the day. But, yeah. So, today, Pedri, a player from Barcelona who I think they got this season, I believe. Yeah, and they're loaned straight out to Las Palmas in the second division. Again, it's on the latest database. That was launched 2 days ago, my time, 3 or 4 days, yours, something like that. So he can play across the front line. He's naturally on his right foot, weak on his left, so that rules out left winger for me. So right wing, sorry. Left wing is where I play him. Great dribbling and first touch for a 16-year-old. Vision, fantastic as well. 17 flair. Tries club balls often, runs the ball often. So dribbling handy when you've got that trait as well. And yeah. Good natural fitness, 15 natural fitness. So, yeah, let's go and have a look at how he is going to get on the first little jump. So, folks, he's now back at Barcelona in the first team, and we've seen increases in his dribbling and first 17, passing 16, technique 16, flair 18, vision 17, getting faster, acceleration up to 16, pace up to 14. And we've got one more player trait, which is plays 1-2s often. So it's curious where they're playing him this season. They're playing him central attacking mid, which, yeah. I don't have problems with that, really. I would say maybe his long shots are slightly... I don't know, really. It's not that bad. I mean, dribbling and good vision, good passing. I can see him in a cam. I just think with the dribbling and the pace being not bad, I think I'd be leaning more towards the wide area. But then again, maybe got better players out there than Pedri at this point. Injury record, only one serious injury for a dislocated shoulder. That was out for 2 months. The rest are pretty much okay. Let's have a look at his career stats. So, Las Palmas. His first season got 3 goals, 3 assists. Went back to Barcelona B and didn't play much. Again, non-competitive football, got 14 goals. Then basically the same for a couple of seasons. Didn't really do that much of an impact. But then suddenly it's all clicked in this current season. He's got 11 goals, or last previous season, sorry. 11 goals and 4 assists. He's got a lease clause, he's going to get £143 million. So, but again, we've seen before Barcelona players that they do like to have this kind of big fees for these guys. But then again, you never know. Everything's different. You know, if you target him early on and really work at it, you never know, do you? So, yeah, let's keep it going. Well, folks, he's now at Man City and he is currently out with a hip injury for 2 to 3 months, which is slightly disappointing. But... Do I have to go for all this? I mean, do I have to? I mean, just look at him. He's fantastic. He's amazing. He is a poor man's Bruno Fernandes. That's just me being to give you context, guys, where it's been recorded, this is after the Watford game on the Sunday. I'm just in a great Bruno. I'm in love with Bruno Fernandes. It's amazing what a quality player does when you sign him, isn't it? You know, it's strange, isn't it? Come on. I mean, quality player. Player traits, we'll go to development and see a bit better. He tries kill balls often, plays 1-2s, switch balls over flank, and runs both. So the only new one there is the switch balls over flank. So, yeah, probably more of a cam. They seem to agree with that. Injury record. Okay. Another injury here for 2 months with a hip injury. Interesting. But 4 weeks out currently with against Barcelona. Interesting. Interesting time in there. So, let's have a look how he's got. Oh, God. Okay. So, first year, we saw that's what we got to before. Went 11 goals and 4 assists. Then he got 8 and 12, excuse me. Then 14 and 8. £105 million City spent on him. And I want FFP looking at that again, please. Mind you, yeah, they're probably... that's a lot of money, isn't it? But then 13 goals, 14 assists, then 14 and 19 assists. So we've seen a couple of reviews so far that when the fees have been massive for the last 2 reviews we've done, but the players are delivering. For me, I look at these transfers and these players with the mentality of it doesn't matter what they cost if they're playing well. Nobody's ever, ever, ever complained about a big transfer fee or commented that, oh, well, he's scoring lots of goals, but oh, the fee was really high. I don't care if a guy costs 200 million quid. If it's all above board and he bangs the goals in or whatever he's supposed to do, then I don't care. So, yeah, this kid is fantastic, but a lot of money. I wonder if that was a loose clause. It wasn't before, was it? So, anyway, let's continue to another jump. We're going to go to around 30 years old, guys, because I found that when we got into 32, we were in 34. We're kind of ending it on like the down spiral, but you guys give some feedback on that in the comment section about what age to end these reviews on. Do you want to end them in their prime, like at 30 years old, something like that, and don't go above that, and this is a striker or a freak of a player? Just let me know, guys, some guidance on that, because I just don't like ending on like a really bad but I could suppose, I don't know, an idea. I'm going to try something. Well, guys, he's moved to PSG for probably like 200 million quid, and again, just look at him. I mean, come on. I mean, I don't have to describe this guy. I really don't. I'm not going to go for numbers. You can see the numbers on the screen. This guy is a phenomenon. I'm loving these technical stats. I'm loving the mental stats. I don't think he's a perfect player, but he's pretty well, damn well close to it. He's amazing. He's fantastic. I think you could play him anywhere in the front three. I think you'd be okay. Maybe not so much right wing because of the whole weak foot left foot kind of thing. But dude, come on. I mean, history of his injuries. Again, another film of injury. And he's still balling out here. I mean, 3 serious injuries and he's still balling out. So how much? Oh, £85 million, a bit lower. So that first season he got 13 and 14, then got 14 and 19. Then got 8 and 6. That must be... Okay, that's interesting. Moved to PSG. And they got 15 and 16. 17 and 13. 20 and 22. Has this guy won the Ballon d'Or? I'm just curious. Has he won the Ballon d'Or? He's won the... is there a landmark here? I'm just trying to see where it would be. Been the award, wasn't it? Has he won the Ballon d'Or? Unless I'm in the complete wrong position, let's keep scrolling through. I don't see. Is there a way of looking at this, guys? Is it the World Player of the Year? Yes, yeah, there we go. Let's have a look. He has not. He has not won the Ballon d'Or. Who is he? Sorry, guys. I need to get along to my United save going. I really do. I get curious, guys, in these reviews, like things are going on, you know. But how is that won the Ballon d'Or with these stats? I mean, wow. Once a new deal, use a good form. Is he on 245k? What's a new... mean, to be fair, it's a great time to ask for it, isn't it? 20 goal, a goal and assist every game, at least, every other game. Brilliant stuff. Right, we're going to do a couple more years and see how he gets on. He's at Liverpool. He's ruined it. Dyer's not signing him. He goes to Liverpool. Don't do it. You know, he's not worth getting there. Anyway, still good. We're seeing drop-off now in his physicals. Still got the technical abilities at 30 years old. I think any further now, he starts seeing drop-offs. If I go to like 32, 33, 34, he drops off. But again, let me know, guys, if you want to see those. And then what I'll do, I'll do something in a second that will be like a way of counteracting that. Because I just didn't like ending it on the lowest of the stats, technically, in terms of the peak, whatever. You know what I mean? So injury course, look at this again. Another film of injury for a broken foot. Well, not another broken foot, but, you know, another film of injury. So, it's okay, it's Chris, that's it. So, Pierce, where's that? That's the year he got 20 and 22. Then he got 15 and 18. Went to Liverpool and got 8 and 7. Liverpool clearly can't use him, right? Potential fee of 75 million. You know what? I think 75 is a bit much. I think about 80 million is about right. But then again, like I said, if you can afford it and you build balls out for you, you ain't gonna complain, are you? Quality player. So we're going to jump back. I'm going to do something here now just to end it on a bit more positive. So we're going to end it on this bit here, what I would consider his prime years on the save. And this is a new process of doing these reviews. Rather than end it on them being 34, having no pace and technicals dropping, end it on what we consider to be their prime years on the review. And then it looks more positive. So the plus side of this guy is technically he is absolutely outstanding. I think mental stats, there's nothing there that really worries me. I'm looking at the teamwork could be an issue. But it doesn't look like it. He's getting 22 assists. So provision is great. Off, you know, leadership, but again, not an issue for me. Based on the overall picture, it's fantastic. I mean, strength is not that bad. It's not brilliant, but again, that's more like me trying to find errors. Nick and pick this guy. The negatives are, the only negative I can really have is that the transfer fee is high from Barcelona, but then again, that's one review. I don't know if I did this again whether the fees would be like the same or not. You never know if Barcelona get an insane regen or sorry, new gen. I'm calling regens, just I've been calling for years, not changing it. If they get an insane regen and they pick him over him for a reason, then you might get, you know what I mean, things can change. But I think if you were to get this guy in your team and play him, you would not be disappointed in him. There's so many players I would love to sign for a long-term saves, and I think this guy is definitely one of them if you can get him, but he's a lot of money. If you're a Barcelona fan and you want to do Barcelona save with him, then and it's helped you out, then I hope you let me know how he's got on for you. So yeah, guys, thanks for watching. Next episode, there is no player. There's no player at the moment, at time recording, for a review. So if you want to get your player in, please feel free. I am open to doing redos, but right now I think there's enough people, enough players that we could do that are not redos. But I'm going to do it on the new database. I'm going to try and remember to put the bloody database title, the number in the video title, so you know it's an updated database. I'll say it in the episode anyway. But I guess, like I said down below, guys, if you enjoyed this video, and I hope you have, hit the like button down below. We've got a really good couple of reviews in a row so far. On these last two reviews, and I'm really, really enjoying this series. It is my favourite series to do because I just love looking at these players and just uncovering these gems that I would never even consider signing and then, you know, taking back into my own save. Also down in the comment section below, guys, if you're a viewer of the Ajax save as well, am I allowed to sign these players on my Ajax save if I get the chance to do so, or is it cheating because I've already done the review of them? I may mention that in the next episode, next one I record as well, but is it allowed? I mean, I'm not too fussed either way, and there's plenty of players I can sign, but I just thought if I can get the guys, I know they're going to be good. Is it cheating? Should I be allowed to do it or not? Let me know in the comments section. I'll probably say this again in the next episode of Ajax, so it's more relevant. But until next time, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, hit the like button down below. If you want to see more from this series, hit the subscribe button as well. And check out all the links down below to all the various avenues of content and communication. But until next time, thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye. Oh, I'm on the side.